Hello and welcome back to my channel. So some days back I had asked you in my community section whether you guys use some sort of planner for the year, and a lot of you actually use a planner, so I'm really happy about that and I think it's the best thing ever. And if you're really serious with your goals, with your dreams and really want to set the tone for a good year, I definitely suggest you invest in a good planner. Now the planner that I use year after year is this one. This is the Leonie Dawson goals workbook. This is called the My Shining Year Life Goals Workbook. So I have been using this, in fact, for a very long time. Like, I started using this for the very first time in 2014. So yes, it has been a very long time for me with this books. Of course, the pattern of the workbooks has changed, and this year, this is the kind of workbook that she has. So I basically invest in the Life Goals workbook, and this is basically the 2021, and I will just take you through the pages. I'll just have a flip through session so you can see what the workbook looks like. I will leave a link for this workbook in the description box below so that if you want to get this one, you can just get it easily. And this is the cover, really pretty again. And as soon as you open it, you have this beautiful section where you can sort of stick your picture and write your details. And just the first pages, and overall these are the kind of sections you will find. So you just have a bit of everything, which I think is super cool. And yeah, these are the testimonials of people who've been using it. Here we go. And this is Leonie Dawson, and she is the author of this book, and she just wears a lot of hats. She is just the coolest. And here she talks about, you know, whether you need to fill all the sections of the book and the results that you can get if you actually work on the book itself and how to use it. Like, this is really important. Of course, you can use it the way you want to, but this is just a guideline. And this is, I think, the most important section of the entire planner, because this is like the 2019 closing ceremony. And this is just, you know, to review what you've done in the past year and all the lessons that you've learned, basically. And, you know, things that you've liked, things that you haven't liked, like your favorite food, your restaurant, which is your favorite, and new things that you did, and, you know. Again, some things that you like, some things you regretted, things that affected you. And this is basically about what did not work and what did work. Like relationships, you have travel and adventure, creativity, self-care, home and community. Like in terms of your career, finances, what has worked for you, what hasn't worked for you. And yes, and how this year basically transformed you, the lessons that you learned, and what did 2019 lead you to? Like, you know, if 2019 has been a year of lessons, what did they teach you about yourself? And, you know, so just rant about 2019 so that you just clear the year and be grateful for whatever lessons you've learned, and, you know, then be ready to welcome your 2020. And we begin with the new year. Are you ready? So what you most want to experience, what you want to attract to yourself this year, and things that you want to bring to yourself. And now we come to the creative goals, the creativity. And what are your creative goals? Like, just filling out this workbook can be one of your creative goals. And these are some resources that you can actually use. You can learn how to make candles, pottery, and so on. And these are some books to help you get more creative. And these are your soul goals, like goals in terms of your spirituality, if you want to attend any spiritual classes or, you know, just go a lot inward. And these are again spiritual resources, books to help you connect with the spirit. And your mind is especially important in this age of the courses you like to take, the workshops you want to attend. And these are resources for your career, good books again. And your relationships, like, you know, what are your goals for your relationships, basically? How you want to spend time with your friends and so on. And this is your family. Family is really important. So what are your family goals? And what do you want to do for your family? Do you want to plan any trips with them? And, you know, if you have kids, like, how can you help your kids? And just sort of your family life goals. And your body, this is like how you take care of your body, your health goals, like if you want to join a gym, take a particular class, and so on. So if you have any activities that you want to take to sort of, you know, just get moving again, so this is something that you can look into. And we come to the dreams. So these are for your house. And if you have any goals for your home, if you want to renovate, if you want to make some changes, and you know, these are again different sections of your house that if you want to make any changes or, you know, work on it. So this is that section. And adventure. This is easily my most favorite section, because here, you know, you actually have to make a note on the places you want to travel. And I just have a lot of travel goals. I think this is definitely a miracle journal. And yes, we come to finances, which is really important. Like, what are your saving goals and how much you want to earn this year? Especially if you're a creative person, if you're an artist, or if you have a YouTube channel, or, you know, something like that. So this is in terms of your income, how you want to increase your income, and, you know, your expenses part, how you can bring down your expenses. And if you have a debt, so how you can work towards paying off your debt, and, you know, actually increase your savings, how you can increase your assets and, you know, get rid of your liabilities. And these are some really good books, I must say, when it comes to, you know, talking about money. And again, here we have your community, your goals towards your community. Like, you know, how you can contribute to the world, how you can, you know, make some changes to the world, like, you know, how much you can donate to your charity. So this is something that you can, you know, write down, how you can help your own community. And books that can, you know, help you sort of take charge. And this is the self-care section, and you can actually plan a retreat, like a time you can take out for yourself and your friends. And these are really, really good. These are days that you can take for yourself, things you can give yourself permission for. And your mottos, like, you know, things you want to do for yourself. And things you celebrate about yourself. I think that's really important. We have to learn to sort of appreciate ourselves as well. And here we have our shining habits. And habits that can help you. And here you have your support. Like, we all need certain support in our life. And you have resources. And now we come down to my favorite section. Now, I just have to talk about this section specifically, because this section is like the total magical section, because honestly, all the to-do things that I've written out here in these pages, starting from 2014, somehow I have managed to make them come true, or they just have come true magically. So don't forget to specially work on these pages, because I don't know, they just seem to work really well. Again, affirmations is something that I really like to work on, because somehow affirmations really work, and if you do practice, then you can sort of, you know, attract a lot of good things in your life. At least this is what I believe. So again, this is an important section. And this is something that I really like to, the dream board part. Like, I generally make a collage, like stick pictures of whatever it is that I want to attract in my life, and, you know, just attract them to me and work towards them. Again, if you have like a big goal or something that really needs planning, so I suggest you write the goal down here and sort of make small pointers as to, you know, what are the little things, little step that you can take to make those dreams come true or to meet that goal. So this is a really nice page for just planning. And you have multiple sections like that. And these are the monthly check-ins, which I think is a new feature. So if you have like, you know, goals that you've set for yourself like month-wise, so you can sort of, you know, have that accountability for yourself when it comes to these monthly checkups. Of course, this is not to, you know, intimidate yourself or to put any pressure, but it's always nice to sort of, you know, realign yourself with your goals. And yeah. October, November. And about Leonie, she is the one. She's literally one of my most favorite people on this planet. She's just super cool. Don't forget to check her out. And again, few notes for you to sort of, you know, doodle on, work on, and, you know, so on. And these are lined pages and unlined. So even if you want to stick pictures here or, you know, do something creative, you can. That's about it. We have sort of reached the end of the workbook. So this is the workbook that I actually buy every year, and I make sure that I really do this and really you know, work on it. I take my time. So this is sort of my creative project of every other year, and I really like it. Like, another reason why I really wanted to introduce you guys to this is, you know, this is really a very cool way to sort of plan your year and, you know, really get into the goal setting and just, you know, laying a foundation for a good year. And that is the reason I really enjoy planners, and this is definitely my favorite planner, and one that I will definitely be buying year after year. So what I'll do is I'll leave a link for this one in the description box down below. You can get it from Amazon. And yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this little planner edition of mine. And I will see you again in my next video with yet another planner. Till then, bye-bye.